Greetings, Jelly Spoons! Welcome back to this episode of Monday Madness, the first for a very long time. I am back, and I'm going to take you in voiceover form through a day. I had a day, to quote Steed Bonnet. I went to look at the wonderful exhibit about musicals and costumes at the London V&A Museum. And this one, right off the bat, is the first one you walk into. It is Scar from The Lion King. Good lord, just look at the tail. Look at the tail. I love all the crazy details on this. All the little claws and the colours and the scar over the eye. I love this so much. This next costume is one of a kind. No category. It is Catherine of Aragon from Six. And I had not realised until I got this close to the thing just how many bits of blingy jewellery are on it. It is just incredible. And this is Jamie from Everyone's Talking About Jamie. All these costumes, basically all my favourite ones, are very, very shiny. Speaking of shiny, here is another shiny one. Now, I had not appreciated just how many colours were in this particular Elphaba costume. I had never seen it up close. I've seen it on the stage, I've seen it in video form, but because I'd never got this close to it, I've never appreciated just how colourful it is. And oh, that was stunning. And this one is Satine, of course, from Moulin Rouge. I love that they put her on a swing. I wish the swing was a little bit lower so I could see a bit more of the corset, but my god, was it stunning. And this is where it got really exciting because I managed to see three things that are just super meaningful to me. So, more about them in a moment. Here we go. Every single costume in this collection was absolutely stunning in its own way. I have been paying particular attention to the details and looking at how I would make them, for example, and I want this. I want to make this. This one is from Faust, and I just love all these little details. Look at this. It's like, yeah, this is the devil, essentially. I love this. Willy Wonka as well. Oh, good lord. The sheer number of colours in this costume is incredible, but they all work, and they all have patterns, and the tie has stripes, even though you won't necessarily be able to see them, and it's just so damn awesome. And the cane as well. I love the fact that it is just a cane that has been painted and covered in a bit of glitter, and of course, kinky boots. I mean, who else is going to wear boots like this? Fabulous costume. Look at it. Just so shiny. I have a type. And here we go with another one of my favourite musicals. One of my favourite British musicals, this one, Matilda. I loved seeing this on stage. This is a little Matilda costume. Look at the detailing. And good lord, Trunchbull is quite terrifying, isn't she? Look at her. Look at that massive belt. I adore this costume, even down to the shoes. They just feel so in character. Even just standing next to this mannequin, you get a sense of sort of ominous malice, and I don't want to go to Turkey. And this is another costume that I really loved as well. Look at the detailing, look at the colours, just all the different bits and pieces. And then behind it as well, you can see more fabulous costumes. Look at the hat. I love this hat. The clown costume at the back as well, I also love. I wish I could have seen that a bit closer up. This one too, very Pennywise, sorry about that. But again, loving all the details, and look at these. Oh, just all the shapes and details and the colours and these feathers, good lord. I've been looking at how they've been making them and what fabrics they use and things like this, and these ones just look so intricate, but really are quite simple to make. And this is one of the big reasons why I just love costumes and costume design so much. Once you learn the techniques, and even not the complicated ones, quite simple ones, once you know how to do them, you can make almost anything. This I decided I would quite happily wear as just a jacket, casually, with the belt. I'd wear that very happily. Now in comparison, this next costume may seem very, very plain, but I love it so much and it meant a great deal to me to actually be able to see it. This is a Matthew Bourne Swan Lake costume. This one was worn by Ashley Bain, and look at it. I want to make one of these. It's stunning. I love this show so much. I had a moment looking at these two costumes where I thought that instinctively your eye is drawn to the dress, but actually the tailoring on that suit is impeccable, and yeah, it just really gets undervalued, I think, sometimes. And look at this one. This one is a queen costume. Good god, the detailing, and just taking you back to Matthew Bourne Swan Lake because, oh, it makes me so happy. Now this I love. It reminded me of Howl's Moving Castle a little bit. I know, every time I see diamonds I think of Molly Morgan Howl now. But just look at the embroidery and the details. And moving into this one from, I think it was Antony and Cleopatra, look again, the embroidery, the detailing, and that neckline. And again, more feathers. And these were done in a different way to the last ones. And these are plastic jewels. The V&A actually has a video on how they restored this costume a little bit. So go check that one out if you want to watch that one. And this again at the back, look at it. Beautiful, stunning, gorgeous. Speaking of beautiful, stunning, and gorgeous, look at this dress with all the florals and the details. Oh my lord. Everywhere you look, there's more. even on the sleeves and in the hem and in the bows. And I really like these sort of wig placeholder things they've got as well. I think they were very cool. And again, look, all the details in this suit. Oh my god. I spent a good 15 minutes kneeling down and looking at the lining of this from sort of a weird angle. And then we moved into set and set design for a little bit. This one was for Hamlet, I believe, and I thought it looked really cool. And the more you look at it, the more you actually do think, yeah, that suits Hamlet. This one was for Swan Lake, not the Matthew Bourne Swan Lake, the sort of classic ballet. Very dark, but you can sort of just about see all the details and the figures and the shapes. This one I recognised at once. That one was for Sweeney Todd. This one is just beautiful looking greenhouses. I love this effect. And this one, fairly more minimal, but again, look at all the details and how everything is staged and the big pieces at the back and everything. This one was for The Turn of the Screw. Ooh, haunting. And then I saw this and the day just got even better. So this is a flying harness from the 1904 production of Peter Pan. The 1904 production. The first one. The flying harness. I was within half a meter of the 1904 stage harness. Oh, it was so exciting. This also made me excited too. So this is a costume for the engineer from Miss Saigon. Love that show. Love the engineer as a character. And this really broad-shouldered costume, it was huge. I also decided that I must get better at drawing my costumes because look at this, it's just so beautiful. So yeah, that's a goal for me in the next few years. I'm going to get better at drawing in general. And now we come to something very special. It's interesting because the three things that excited me the most about this collection are three of, well, some of the plainer things in it. And this is number three, a huge reason why I went. This is one of the gauntlets worn in Matthew Bourne's Edward Scissorhands. And why is this so exciting to me? Well, I am embarking upon making this costume. My Patreons already know this, they have known for a while. I am currently in the very beginning stages of making my own Edward Scissorhands. So getting to see a piece of the costume in person up close so I could take loads of pictures and look at all the details and the mechanisms was absolutely perfect for me. I do wish the rest of the costume had been on display because they do have it. They do have some wonderful pictures on the website that I have been using. I really wish that had been out on display as well. However, the glove was absolutely amazing. So if you would like to help me in this crazy endeavor, which I'm going to try to get done in time for Christmas, because come on, Edward Scissorhands is such a good Christmas cosplay. And also, the tour is coming out next year and I am going to see it because I have snagged tickets. I'm very excited, so I'd like my costume in time for that. Don't worry, I won't be wearing it to the theater. And also, it will be the anniversary in 2025, the 20 years of Matthew Bourne's Edward Scissorhands. So I would love to do some promo photos for that. So to support me in this, if you would like to, you can go to my Ko-fi page, ko-fi.com/mockersnoise, or you can go to my Patreon and there you can do it monthly as well. You get to see behind the scenes bits and pieces and I'll update you on various things. And now that I'm fully recovered, I will be posting way more as well. All right, thank you, my wonderful jelly beans. Have a wonderful day. Tell me what you're doing in the comments down below. And something before you go. A little sneak preview of where I'm at with my Edward Scissorhands cosplay. Goodbye.